The Philippine government touts a record number amount of approved investments this year. A trade official says investments amounted to 1.16 trillion pesos, beating the 1.14 trillion in 2019. Undersecretary Seferino Rodolfo attributed the higher investment approvals to improved government promotion of the country to foreign investors. Most of the approved investments were for the digital and renewable energy sectors. Rodolfo says they expect these to generate as much as 200,000 jobs for Filipinos next year. If you're deciding whether to continue climbing the corporate ladder or switching jobs in 2024, a career coach says the answer could be found in a company's culture. Erwin Ursua, Chief Growth Officer at Win Within Marketing Consultancy, notes younger workers are now paying more attention to career growth opportunities that an employer offers. He tells those looking for jobs in 2024 to ask questions about the company during the interview process to determine if your prospective employer is the right fit for you.
It's better to seek work right now that, again, if people before are looking for stability, right now they're looking for employee value proposition. Those are the most Gen Zs are looking at right now, like where do they place in the company right now? Do they have a career that they can assure that they will be promoted soon, or stepping up as we talked a while ago in the corporate ladder, will they be promoted right away, or is the organization that stable for to give them the goal that they want in life?
The passenger volume at Metro Manila's main gateway has surpassed the levels recorded last year as travelers head out of the metro ahead of the new year. Our correspondent Johnson Manabat now on the line with the latest from the NAIA. Johnson?
Hi, Ron. Good afternoon. The Manila International Airport Authority, or MIAA, assured the public that they are in close coordination with the local government units of Pasay and other government agencies to address the heavy traffic situation within the vicinity of the Nino Aquino International Airport. MIAA Public Affairs Department Officer in Charge, Connie Bungag, said they are aware of the complaints of passengers going to and out of the airport, especially during rush hour. MIAA records showed passenger statistics at the airport from December 1 to 28, 2023, have reached more than 3.7 million, or about 14.10% higher than the 3.2 million recorded last year. Bungag advised passengers going to the airport to allot at least 2 hours of time allowance for domestic flights and 3 hours for those who are in, or rather for those who have international flights. The MIAA management said it has also beefed up its security protocols at the airport by deploying more patrols. It added that the PNP has also deployed more police personnel at the airport to augment their security force to monitor cab drivers, victimizing passengers and offering higher fare rates. Bungag said airport authorities have apprehended some colorum taxis which have already been endorsed to the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board. Meanwhile, the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, or CAAP, said in a statement that La Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista inspected the communications, navigations, surveillance, traffic management system Friday. That's January 1, 2023. Flights were grounded in the entire Philippine airspace for several hours due to technical issues linked to a power loss at the Philippine Air Traffic Management Center, which houses the system for monitoring flights. CAAP said it assured DOTR of the efficiency of the equipment, including the redundancy of the uninterruptible power supply, or UPS, for continuous operations of the air traffic control. Ron.
Johnson Manabat with that story. Thanks.
The Philippine police have filed charges against the suspects allegedly involved in the deadly bombing in Marawi City. Police Chief Benjamin Acorda Jr. says they're also waiting for a warrant of arrest so they can resume manhunt operations for other suspects that remain at large. At least 4 people were killed and dozens others were injured after a bomb went off in a university gymnasium last December 3.
Meanwhile, Philippine police confirmed the death of one person from a vehicle accident at a bank in Quezon City. The woman was among the 6 hospitalized after an SUV crashed into a BDO Unibank branch Thursday in the greater Lagro area. The condition of the driver of the vehicle was not immediately known, but police say they will file homicide and multiple injuries charges against the driver. BDO, meanwhile, says it is coordinating with authorities following the crash. It also assured the victims of support.
The entire Philippine health sector is on code white until January 4, 2024. This as the health department anticipates an influx of patients before and after the New Year revelries. DOH Assistant Secretary Albert Domingo explains code white means hospital personnel are on active on-call status. Other needs like x-ray plates and laboratory requirements are also available without requiring payments from patients. The DOH urges the public to opt for safe ways to usher in the new year.